Now, I know that a lot of people say that one of their greatest fears is speaking in public. Do you have a lot of people who come to you because of that?
Yes, I do. So I have a presentation boot camp specifically to help people develop their voice, but also build their confidence, get over that fear. But then a lot of people, after they've done the boot camp, or some of them just do one-on-one coaching. So I've done work with, for instance, Ian Furr, the old CEO of Sorbet. For instance, he's a brilliant storyteller, gets paid a lot of money for telling his stories. You know, he's written The Soul of Sorbet, and he basically created the entire culture of sorbet in South Africa and taking it overseas as well. But he would have nightmares. So his wife was using me for her beauty therapy institute to train her franchisees on emotional intelligence. And she said to me, "Don't you know someone that could help my husband overcome this fear?" So what is interesting, Melanie, is I studied NLP, so that has all to do with like the patterns of the brain. So if a person has a fear of public speaking, it's because somewhere in your life something happened to make you now react in a certain way. So maybe it was you were in primary school, you were in high school, and you were asked to stand up and speak, and someone threw you with water. You know how kids are. And now you've created this strategy, coping mechanism in your brain to say, like, I need to protect myself. It's not a safe environment. And then what ends up happening on a psychological level is you trigger yourself to go red in the face, or to start stammering, or to start speaking fast, or, you know, to start having nightmares at night, or whatever it might
Or
be.
just go
So,
blank.
you know what I mean? So, some of those, I mean, like you're saying, the going blank, some of those are literally techniques that you can learn so that you have a backup. So that if you freeze on the spot, you can refer to something, have cue cards, have a mind map, all of those kinds of things. Or even slides could help you. You know, just bring you back, like, what is my next thing that I need to speak about? But when you're actually sitting with that pathway that you've created with NLP coaching, you can actually change it. So you can completely override that fear and build a new strategy for you to be confident. But that has to be in the one-on-one capacity.